Hi guys, welcome to my kitchen and I'm so excited because today I'm going to be showing you how to make the poached egg mushroom toast. This is super yummy and it really takes very few ingredients. I know we are all in lockdown, so I made sure that the ingredients are like close to the bare basics that are easily available in most kitchens, and if not for the mushroom, maybe that you can easily substitute with some other vegetable or skip it altogether actually. So yeah, the best thing about this is that versus the normal fried egg or the boiled egg or the omelette, this egg looks so fancy and it actually feels like you're having a super expensive brunch right at your home. So without wasting any further time, let me quickly show you guys what we have here. I have some multigrain bread. Now feel free to use any bread of your liking. You can use white bread, brown bread, multigrain bread, gluten-free bread, any bread of your liking. Then we have some mushrooms. We're going to be caramelizing mushrooms. I absolutely love caramelized mushrooms, and this is what gives that poached eggs toast a whole new spin altogether. So a couple of mushrooms, I have a slice of cheese, I have one egg with me, I have some butter, and then some regular seasonings, which you can obviously alter as per your liking. I will tell you as and how we go ahead with the recipe. Okay, so first things first, what we are going to do is heat some water, like bring it to a boiling point. So I have my water already filled in here. I'm just going to put on the gas and I am going to cover it so that it comes to a boiling point a little faster. I'm also going to put the other pan on for our mushrooms. Okay, so now we're quickly going to be slicing our mushrooms. Nothing too fancy, just the normal thin slices. Okay, so we already have our chopped mushrooms here, and all we're gonna do right now is caramelize them a little in butter. Okay, so I'm just gonna be adding a little bit of butter onto the hot pan. So once it turns a little brown, I'm just going to throw in all our mushrooms. You're just going to lightly toss the mushrooms around. If you feel like you want to add a little more butter at this point, feel free to do so. Now I'm going to be taking a little bit of salt and just going over the mushrooms. So like you can see, our mushrooms are already done. They have a really beautiful brown caramelized color, and this is exactly what we want. Meanwhile, our water is boiling. So once you see that your water is boiling, you want to reduce the temperature a little, reduce the flame, okay, and let it just calm down a little. You want the water to not be bubbling so much when you put in the eggs. So while the water rests for a bit, we'll just go and prep our egg for the drop. Now, one important tip is to make sure that your egg is actually at room temperature. Like, because if the egg is really cold, you might not get the best looking poached egg. So just leave it outside the fridge for a couple of, for half an hour or a couple of minutes before you want to drop it into the water. And in case you're running a little late and your egg is really cold, you can actually also leave it in a glass of like warm water so that it just hits the room temperature a little faster. So we have our egg right here. Now I just wanted to tell you a couple of things that in my experience have helped me to make the perfect poached egg. So First things first, you will need a little bit of white vinegar. Okay, what this does is, like, when you drop in 1 tablespoon of white vinegar into water, the hot water that we are prepping right now, it actually binds the egg whites together. So when you drop it in the water, it will help you bind the egg together, and it'll stay, you know, put together. And don't worry too much about the taste of the vinegar, because it doesn't really transfer onto the egg at all. There are a lot of ways to make a poached egg, and some people also suggest using salt if you don't have vinegar. But in my personal experience, the egg tends to fray a little, but maybe you can give that a try, you know, like, why not? Just see what works for you. But this is how I like to make my poached eggs. Another thing is that even when it comes to poaching the egg, a few people like to create the whirlpool, which is basically, like, before dropping the egg, you swirl the water around and then drop the egg in that whirlpool. But I personally feel like even just a basic drop in, like, say 4 to 5 inch of water gives me, like, really good results. So I don't see the fuss around that. But again, this is what works for me. I am really no expert, so you guys should totally try this out. It's just my job to tell you a few things that I have tried and tested along the way. So yeah, what I'm going to be doing is just taking a spoonful of white vinegar and dropping it in the water. So this is basically what you need. It should be bubbling at the base, but not too much happening at the top. So once you have your water bubbling like this, drop in 1 tablespoon of white vinegar. And once that is done, you get ready to drop in the egg into the hot water. What we need to do now is make sure the flame is not too high and just cover it for around 4 minutes. So while the egg is poaching, I'm quickly going to put in my bread in the toaster. Okay, so now our bread is slightly toasted. Feel free to toast it as you like. If you like it a little more crisp, then do that. I like it a little medium, especially when it comes with the poached egg. And I'm just going to go ahead and butter it up. So now you're just going to take your slice of cheese and put it on the toast. Okay, so in my experience, poaching the eggs for around 3 to 4 minutes when it's covered usually works well if you want that really nice soft yolk and the whites are really well done. But you know, like, the temperatures differ from gas to gas, so try to eyeball it, and, like, I think it'll take you, like, a couple of tries before you really crack the timing. But in my personal experience, around 3 to 4 minutes is a good enough estimate. You can always get the egg on the spatula and then just press the yolk a little bit, and it should be soft and tender, and that's when you know that it's nicely done. Now we've buttered and put cheese on our toast, we're gonna go ahead and layer it up with our caramelized mushrooms. So like you can see, our egg is done. At this point, you can always touch the yolk and it should be a little soft like this. Just get it onto a piece of tissue and drain the extra liquid. So we have a poached egg here. It's really nice and tender. So I'm just going to transfer this onto our toast. There you go. Now I've already assembled the first toast and I'm going to show you how. Go ahead and add a dash of pepper onto your toast as per your liking, and then go ahead and sprinkle your favorite herbs. I have used the oregano here, but you can totally use oregano, parsley, chili flakes, whatever you have accessible. I'm all about the plating, so don't forget to garnish it with your favorite herb or condiments, whatever's accessible around. And voila, there it is, our really beautiful looking mushroom poached egg toast. So my toast is all ready and it's screaming out to me, and I just cannot wait to dig in and show you guys the magic of a poached egg. Just wait and watch. There you go guys, it was so simple to create this poached egg mushroom toast, and I really hope you guys will give this a try the next time you're craving something a little fancy but simple right in your home. And this tastes so good with freshly squeezed orange juice, so if you have that then nothing like it. It's one of my favorite combos. Also feel free to swap the mushrooms with your favorite veggies, because this combination, the cheese bread and the poached eggs, tastes good with so many different vegetables. So yeah, like, make it your own. And if you happen to try this, do tag me on Instagram. Make sure you're following me there. I'm just gonna leave it here. It goes by the name of Streaky Fall. I'd love to see your recreations. And while you're at it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because trust me, there's so much more coming your way, right from simple recipes like these to smoothies to baking to like home decor, beauty, fashion. And yeah, just subscribe and hit the bell button, and see you in the next video. Bye.